This is your evening KRQE.com webcast. Mark Ronchetti starts us off with the weather.
Pretty quiet weather-wise over the next couple of days, but it will be cold out there. So tomorrow morning, going to get up with temperatures in many areas in the 20s and even lower. Tomorrow afternoon, temperatures will be similar to today. High 40s, low 50s in most areas with mostly sunny skies. Slight chance of a snow shower across the northern mountains. And then temperatures finally start to moderate by Thursday afternoon. We'll keep the warmer temperatures going through the first half of the weekend. But then by Sunday, we'll get a chance at another storm.
Secretary of State Diana Duran has sent a letter to Attorney General Gary King claiming she has new evidence of voter fraud. Among other things, it says two non-citizens have voluntarily come to her office saying they have been registered to vote for years. One said he'd been voting since 1998. Both asked to be taken off the voter rolls, so they probably won't face charges. Duran also says 100 illegal immigrants have registered to vote over the last 8 years, and 36 have voted, she believes. She plans to release a detailed report on all this on Thursday. A slap on the wrist or a fair fine for a New Mexico company that made a costly mistake, which shut down a busy section of Bloomfield last summer. The Public Regulation Commission fined Sterling Brothers $1,500 for a gas line explosion in August. A Traco operator hit the line, forcing 1,200 people to evacuate their homes and shutting down Highway 62 for a while. The explosion cost $170,000 in damages, but the PRC said the fine is appropriate considering that service was only disrupted for one customer. Join us for more news tonight on KRQE News 13 at 10.